It was the sewing circle day again, at Sarah Gardner's this time. I was late. Everybody else was there when I arrived, and the minute I entered the room I knew something had happened, although I couldn't imagine what. Everybody looked at me in the strangest way. Of course Wilhelmina Mercer was the first to set her tongue going. "Oh, Miss Holmes, have you seen him yet?" she exclaimed. "Seen whom?" I said, non-excitedly, getting out my thimble and patterns. "Why, Cecil Fenwick. He's here in Avonlea, visiting his sister, Mrs. Maxwell." I suppose I did then what they expected me to do. I dropped everything I held, and Josephine Cameron said afterwards that Charlotte Holmes would never be paler when she was in her coffin. If they had just known why I turned so pale! "It's impossible," I said blankly. "It's really true," said Wilhelmina, delighted at this development, as she supposed it, of my romance. "I was up to see Mrs. Maxwell last night, and I met him." "It can't be the same Cecil Fenwick," I said faintly, because I had to say something. "Oh, yes, it is. He belongs in Blakely, New Brunswick, and he's a lawyer, and he's been out west 22 years. He's, oh, so handsome, and just as you described him, except that his hair is quite gray. He has never married. I asked Mrs. Maxwell. So you see he has never forgotten you, Miss Holmes. And, oh, I believe everything is going to come out all right." I couldn't exactly share her cheerful belief. Everything seemed to me to be coming out most horribly wrong. I was so mixed up I didn't know what to do or say. I felt as if I were in a bad dream. It must be a dream. There couldn't really be a Cecil Fenwick. My feelings were simply indescribable. Fortunately, everyone put my agitation down to quite a different cause, and then they very kindly left me alone to recover myself. I shall never forget that awful afternoon. Right after tea I excused myself and went home as fast as I could. There I shut myself up in my room, but not to write poetry in my blank book. No, indeed, I felt in no poetical mood.